Thank you so much for staying here on the JoyNews channel. This is JoyNews Today with me, Ben. It's Abubedu Lansa. Time now to let you know what's happening in other parts of the country. And there's mixed reaction in the one municipality of the Upper West region following the submission of preliminary findings by the four-member joint team tasked to investigate the military brutality in Wa on July 1. In the report, which has been cited by JoyNews, three soldiers on duty on the day have been demoted to junior ranks, whilst eight others have been given a 30-day detention. JoyNews' Upper West regional correspondent Rafiq Salam has more.
Residents and shop owners at the Tendamba Crescent are still recovering from the July 1 Republic Day brutality suffered at the hands of 86 young soldiers. Stream of innocent persons were whipped with canes, others battered with boots, pushed the gutter and asked to lie supine. A dozen of them were subjected to military drills by being asked to roll on the hot asphalted road.
I was asked to go on the floor. So when I went on the floor, then there was a vernacular bucket that people washed their hands. So they carried the water and poured on me and asked me to roll on the floor. So when I was doing that, one of them hit my head with their boots. And when I got up, I began to question them, and one also knocked my head, including.
What they told us was that we should all get down from our motorbikes and get a place to sit down. And shortly after that, they asked us to come and lie down. And then shortly after that, we realized that they started beating people, brutalizing anyone they see on their way.
They were not beating women. They only came into my shop, took lots of sachet water and said thank you. I was frightened to ask for the money.
A four-member joint team was formed by the National Security, comprising two officers from the Military High Command and the National Investigation Bureau, NIB. They began sitting on Monday and have already met at least 16 of the victims and witnesses. The joint team, led by Colonel BZ Ayorogo, also met at least 30 of the 86 rookie soldiers and has already submitted their preliminary findings. The orderly, guard commander, and the sentry has been demoted from their ranks to lower ranks. Eight other rookie soldiers who were seen on various videos brutalizing some residents have been awarded each 30 days in detention.
This is the place where the army brutality took place in Wa. A lot of people in the Upper West region have a lot of reverence for soldiers.
The big question, however, is that can the punishment of demotion and 30-day detention suffice for the brutality they suffered? Or is the punishment less or harsh?
Actually, what I want to be given to them, like, I just want them to just take them out of business. Like, they should just sack them so that they shouldn't be able to go into any forces again.
To me, I was even like scared that maybe I don't want them to sack them, because when they sack them, they'll go out there to be a criminal. Some are even telling to Anne Robert to kill us at the same time as they did. So it's better for them to do that. They should go through the punishment and they should let them remain there. To me, the punishment is cruel.
They should take the said group that acted this way back to Accra or headquarters that they think they can give them discipline. The training that has been given to them has been misappropriately applied.
For some, the respect they used to have for the military has now been flamed out.
I think the respect that the people of Upper West have for the military it has gone off. At first, when you see a military man, you only look at the person and admire being the person being a military man. But for what they did, when you see a military man, you see the person that fear that we used to have that for military is due before you complain has gotten out of us. So we don't have any respect for them.
For most residents in the one municipality, they could not be forgiven or forgotten unless justice has taken its course. For the chain of impunity has permanently been broken for unquestionable crimes such as these. Reporting for JoyNews, Rafiq Salam.